Okay, so in most real estate brokerages, you're going to have one option for earning income. It's simple. Work with buyers, work with sellers, close deals, earn commissions based on those sales closing. And that's option. That's awesome. And it's a great opportunity for you to build a successful real estate business. Now, there's a couple different models out there. And I've been a part of three different real estate models in my real estate career. And one of them was what I just shared with you when I was one of the top RE/MAX agents in the state of Florida. We were closing 120 sales a year, about 30 million in closed volume, earning about 900,000 in gross commission. Pretty good. And I worked for another model where it was very similar and I had very similar results, but we also had profit share, which was cool because it was another way to earn additional income. Now, in the third company that I worked with, again, I had the option to sell real estate and earn income by selling homes, working with buyers, working with sellers. And then there was a two different options. One was you could earn stocks in the company and be an equity owner in the business. And then they also have this revenue share model. Now, hey, everybody, my name is John Dietz. I am a real estate trainer, speaker, and coach, and team builder. And today I'm going to talk to you about the difference between profit share and revenue share. So, first of all, let's just get some assumptions out of the way. And for this example, let's say that we have 100 agents in an office. The average agent, according to the National Association of Realtors, is selling four homes per year. So we're going to take this office of 100 agents with four sales per agent, and we're going to bring it over here. All right. So if the average commission is $10,000, just another assumption. Those four sales times 10,000 equals $40,000 in GCI. That's the total amount of money that is going to come to the brokerage. And if we took that number times 20%, that's the portion that goes to the company dollar or revenue, that would be $8,000 in revenue to the company. Now, we take the same 100 agents times 8,000, that equals $800,000 in total profit. Now, out of that total profit, we have expenses, mainly rent and staff. There's others, but those are the main two. And if we average those two out at $40,000 a month for rent and for staff, it's probably pretty low. It's probably more than that, but we'll go with that. And that's $480,000. We're going to subtract that from the total revenue of $800,000. And what we have left is $320,000 in profit. Now, on average, these companies that are offering profit share, they're going to take about 40% of the total profit, and that's going to go to profit share, which would be $128,000 in this case. So if you're an agent in this office, you have an opportunity to share in $128,000. Now, the main reason for this, if you look at a traditional real estate brokerage, you have the brokerage at the top, and directly beneath the brokerage, you have regional owners. They have to get paid. And then you have, at a local level, you have franchise owners. They want to get paid. And then franchise owners has expenses, again, the two biggest being rent and staff. And then down here at the bottom, guys, is you, the real estate agent. Now, what eXp did is when Glenn Sanford created this model, we eliminated regional owners, we eliminated franchise owners, and of course, we got rid of bricks and mortar rent and staff. And we were able to bring this agent up here in a 50-50 partnership with the company. And this is the whole idea behind revenue share and how revenue share works. So I'm going to take the same numbers that we used on the left side of the board, and I'm going to plug it into a revenue share model. All right. Again, we have 100 agents closing four sales each. Each agent is bringing in $40,000 in commission to the company. If we have a 20% split, then that's bringing in
$8,000 in revenue, in total revenue. We take that times 100 agents, which equals 800,000 in revenue share, or revenue, excuse me. So you have a total of $800,000 in revenue. And EXP has what they call the 50-50 initiative, which means 50% of that revenue goes to the company. That's how they pay their bills. What's left over is profit. And 50% of it goes back to the agents in revenue share. So the agents at EXP are sharing in $400,000 in revenue share versus $128,000 in profit share. It's obviously a bigger number, which means it's a bigger opportunity for real estate agents like you to build a revenue share business that can pay you high six figures every year for the rest of your life. One of the reasons why there are many real estate agents at EXP that are earning over $1 million a year, agents that are earning $2, 3, 4, 5 million a year, it's just math. It's not that one is better than the other. I guess that's a matter of personal perception. And they're just different models. One based on bricks and mortar, traditional real estate model, and the other one based on a cloud-based brokerage where you are 50-50 partnership with the company and you're sharing 50% of the revenue, not 50% of the profit. And it's going to equal to be more money, a lot more money. If you have any questions, reach out to me on John Dietz. I'd love to share more with you on how this works and what we're doing, Monica and I are doing, to build our real estate team that we started building in March of last year based on this platform business in order to create income for our family and live a better life and to be able to leave a legacy for our family. Okay, John Dietz, contact information is below. If you have any questions, you want to talk about the difference between the different real estate models, traditional profit share model, revenue share model, reach out to me. I'd love to chat with you. My contact information is below. And as always, make it a great day.